Everybody and welcome. This is exercise 11-8. So here we have George Zedek Corporation bought a machine on June 1st, 2018 for 31,000 FOB, the place of manufacture. So the cost was 31,000. Freight to the point where it was set up was 200. 500 was expended to install it. So over here, my total basis in this equipment on 6/1/18 is going to be 31,700. So right over here, for my depreciation expense, my acquisition cost is 31,700. I subtract 2,500, which is my salvage value. And I'm dividing this by my estimated useful life of 10 years. So my depreciation expense, at least initially for this question, is going to be $2,920. So I look over here and it tells me on June 1st, an essential part of the machine is replaced at a cost of $1,980 with one designed to reduce the cost of operating the machine. So this is what we call a betterment. Okay, so even though we don't know what the improvement is until in terms of the useful life, it's telling me that it's operating more efficiently. So what I now need to go through and do is add in that cost to my basis. So what I'm gonna do here, my basis as of 6/1/18 was 31,700. I'm adding in my betterment of 1980, and this is on 6/1/19. So my new cost basis going forward as of 6/1/19 is going to be 33,680. Okay. Then it tells me on June 1st, the company buys a new machine of greater capacity for 35,000 delivered, trading in the old machine, which has a fair value allowance of 20. To prepare the old machine for removal from the plant cost 75,000 and expenditures to install the new one were 1,500. It's estimated the new machine will last for 10 years with a salvage value of 4,000 at the end of that time. The exchange has commercial substance. So because I'm doing an exchange of an asset, I need to figure out what is on the date of the asset's disposal, what was the book value of it. So what I now need to do is my new depreciation base as of 6/1/19. So my new cost basis or my acquisition cost is now going to be 33,680. However, in 2018, I took depreciation of 2,920. And I also still have my salvage value, which has not changed. It's still going to be 2,500. So my depreciable base is now going to be 28,260. I'm going to divide this by the estimated useful life, which in this case here is going to be 9 years. Because on June 1st, it was 10 years. Now after I put in this part, it's now at 1 year has passed, so I have 9 years remaining. So my depreciation is going to be 28,260 divided by 9, or 3,140. Okay. So when I exchange this machine on June 1st, what I now need to figure out is, okay, what's the cost basis of the machine when I'm disposing of it? So to go through and to figure that one out, what I need to go through here is I've got this 33,680. Then I had depreciation in 2018 of 229.20. I also had then depreciation for 2019, 2020, 2021. I should say here, this is a depreciation. Okay, let's see here. Let me try to, I always love these dates here. So this is going to be depreciation from 6/1/18 to 5/31/19. So then my depreciation for 5/31/20. 21 and 22 is going to be 3140 times 3. Or 9,420. Because it's straight line, it's going to be the same amount year over year. So the total amount of my book value of the old machine is going to be 21,340. So these two depreciation amounts, or these 4 years of depreciation, that would just be going to accumulated depreciation. So my book value of my old machine is 21,340. So since it has a trade-in value of 20,000, so this is right up here, I'm going to have a loss on the exchange of 1340. And then removal costs. And it cost me to remove the old machine, it cost me $75. So my total loss on this machine is gonna be $1,415. Now you're asking me, well, why did you have to do this? Because if this was a less and we were getting a trade-in valued at 20,000, we would have a gain because this had commercial substance. So that's why I have to go through and to compute it. So now in terms of for the new machine, what is the value of the new machine? So for the new machine, I'm buying a new machine for 35,000, trading in the old machine, which has a fair value and trade-in allowance of 20,000. So what this means, I'm paying cash of 15,000. My trade-in for the old machine is going to be 20,000. And then I have installation on the old machine of 1,500. So my cost basis of the new machine is going to be 36,500. So to determine the amount of the depreciation expense that should be provided for the new machine, the new equipment, this is going to be the acquisition cost minus the salvage value divided by the estimated useful life. So this is going to be 36,500 minus 4,000. Divided by my estimated useful life of 10 years for this new machine. And so over here, this is going to be 32,500 divided by 10, or 3250. So yet again, a good little question here. So kind of fun with the this part over here. So in any event, I want to thank you for joining me here this evening. And I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Stay safe.